Welcome to the Americare Companies. I'm Ellie Kleiman, and I'd like to share something very special with you. The film you're about to see is designed to give you an inside view into the world of home health care and the array of varied services our agency provides. You'll notice our presentation seamlessly combines informative documentary with entertaining dramatization. We are proud to share our story.
I think my father needs another blanket.
Oh, well, Mr. Taylor, good morning. Michael, you're looking well. Your nurses and physical therapists report you're making good progress. Looks like you're almost ready to take that new hip and go home where you belong.
Really?
Really? Already?
Provided, of course, you follow the guidelines for continued recovery, meticulously. And for a while, you'll need round-the-clock care.
Doctor, I don't know if we're ready.
Social worker will take care of all those details for you. But the important thing is, you're on the road to a full recovery.
Is there a list of do's and don'ts for him? For me?
We'll review all the instructions in my office before you go. You'll need to have professional care at home. It's not fast, and it's not easy. Mr. Taylor, you're lucky to have such a devoted family.
Thank you, Doctor. I'm grateful for the second chance.
You'll do fine, Mr. Taylor. Michael, a word, please. Michael, you'll need to pay close attention to your father's condition over the weeks and months ahead. The nurse will review all the instructions, but there are important mental and emotional red flags you need to be aware of.
What do you mean exactly?
Your father's at a particularly high risk for post-surgically induced clinical depression, which would only exacerbate his current symptoms of anxiety. I've asked the hospital social worker to speak to you to arrange home care services.
It's always difficult when you have your own families and now you have to also take care of your parents or grandparents who are ill. It's not just emotional stress, but also a financial stress.
The biggest issue is, what am I going to do with them when they get home? Most of the times, the family doesn't live with the patient. The patient was able to perform things on their own prior to the incident happening. So they don't know what to do. Are they going to have to quit their job and spend 24 hours a day there taking care of their mother and father?
It's a natural thing for a person to become very frustrated and very anxious about, especially you're talking about their parents, when it comes to a situation that they've never experienced before and they have to have 20 questions answered within a 24-hour period.
There's just a whole list of issues and concerns that come about when a loved one is ill.
What is it that they're entitled to? They may have Medicare, which covers certain things. They have Medicaid, or if they don't have Medicaid, how do you go about obtaining it? And then, of course, there's managed care, which oftentimes is very, very limited. And if you need additional services beyond what's covered, how do you go about getting that? Is that something that you have to pay for out of your pocket, or are there other community resources? These are the decisions that you have to grapple with.
We understand what a family member is going through because it can be our mother or grandmother or brother or sister in the same predicament.
Why can't everybody just leave me alone and let me take care of myself? Because the older you get, the more you feel that you're entitled. You're entitled to whatever you want. And very frequently, the reality that you need help takes a long time to sink in. And that's where the family comes in. That's where the family needs to get involved and say, you know, Mom, you really can't do this yourself right now. You need a little bit of help. Or, you know, Dad, we'd like to have someone come in and help you with this just for a little while. Once you get on your feet, we'll be okay.
What we're looking for at Americare for a caregiver is not somebody that is just a very nice person or a sweet person, but really somebody that's compassionate and somebody that's proactive when it comes to helping people.
Let me help you with that.
Oh, thank you, young man. So kind of you.
Of course.
Much appreciated.
Oh, my pleasure.
Thank you
so much.
Okay.
Are you sure?
Yeah, sure.
See you around.
Okay, I hope so.
Ay, hermanito. You're always such a good guy.
Well, why should I be, Juanita? Your little brother's got his own place in New York City now. Why not spread the joy around, huh?
I just hope you're gonna be able to pay for it, Carlos.
Actually, about that, I have a job interview lined up for tomorrow morning.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Tell me, where?
At Americare, that home healthcare agency I was telling you about. They say it's a great place to work. I just hope I get the job.
Oh, they'll take you. How can they resist?
Well, too bad you're not conducting the interview, Nita. You know, I think the job would be something really good for us, for the family, you know? Anyway, thank you for helping me move.
That's what family's all about, Carlos. Don't worry, you'll get the job. You'll see. Things are gonna work out for you here.
I hope so.
Working at Americare as a home health aide is particularly gratifying. It's something that you have an opportunity to get out there and really make a difference in somebody's life.
There are so many advancements when you work in Americare. And we work all as a team, as a family. Everyone is happy. We have progress. We take the best care of our patients. And clinically, I work with patients out in the field also. And they say to me, our patients say to me, Americare is wonderful. They get the best care from their nurses, from their therapists, from the social workers, and from home health aides. So you have to be very, very lucky to work here. And I'm very lucky, and I love working for America, and I hope I work here for another 10 years.
It's a joy to work in a company where you can see that the family is still home and involved with the patient care, and also they're comfortable. It's all about being comfortable. It's nothing like being in the hospital and being inconvenienced day in and day out.
Americare seems to want to nurture their nurses and give them the support and the guidance that they need.
When I'm interviewing a prospective home health aide, everything starts from when they immediately walk in the door. It is very important how they show up for the interview. That says a lot about a person. Once we sit down for the interview, I do get in the aspect how compassionate they are. The skills are very important, but the part about being caring and nurturing for an elderly, someone who's probably physically or mentally challenged, is very important. Not everyone knows how to deal with that. Not everyone fully understand how to deal with that. So when we are interviewing on home health aid, we would like to know that this is something that this person will be able to handle, that they, it's not just a job for them, it's something that they love to do.
I think so, absolutely.
Okay. Well, I'm actually very impressed. You seem motivated, you have very good people skills, and you seem to be sensitive to the needs of others, which is an extremely important quality in our caregivers.
Is that the job offer?
Not exactly. We actually have a home health aid training program, which will begin next week. In order for you to be a home health aid, you do have to be certified. Mm-hmm. Once I get you set up with all the paperwork that you need, I'll see you here next week. Is that okay?
That's great.
Okay, wonderful.
Thank you so much.
Lovely meeting you.
Likewise.
Patients ready to go home, often a family member will consult with the hospital social worker just to determine the next steps.
He's just not the same as he was years ago. After my mother passed away, my wife and I tried to take care of him ourselves, but we're realizing that there's a lot more to it than just helping him eat or dress or get around in the wheelchair. And now, ever since he fell, the littlest thing can agitate him, and sometimes he just seems so sad.
Michael, recovering from serious surgery is a daunting process. And for your father, facing that long road ahead can bring up feelings of anxiety and depression. The good news is there are trained professionals waiting to help him and you. From my experience, utilizing the services of the right home health care agency is invaluable. We've had great experience with Americare.
Americare. How would this work?
A case manager will be assigned to you and your family to help you navigate all of that. You'll be introduced to a well-trained, compatible home health aide. A RN and physical therapist will make home visits. A social worker and perhaps other specialty therapists may come into the home as needed. It'll all be handled by Americare.
It sounds like just what we need.
Americare CSS is able to service a wide variety of ethnic backgrounds. We have many staff members that are bilingual, that are able to communicate well with the patient and the family. We try to associate a specific nurse who speaks a certain language with the patient.
Our in-house staff, the coordinators who actually place the aides on the cases, are just as diverse as our field staff. We have coordinators who speak more than 10 different languages. We have them divided within the office by language and by geography, so that not only do the aides speak the language of the family member, but they also live in close enough proximity that traveling is not a big issue for them. If we need to dispatch another aide, we can get them there very quickly.
We customize our treatment to each client. You know, we don't use a cookie cutter approach. We look at the patient individually and look at what their specific needs are, and then we adjust the treatment, the professional care as needed that best caters to this client.
When the patient is discharged from the hospital, the nurse will meet the patient and the family in the home to evaluate the patient for his needs.
What the nurse is evaluating are safety conditions in the house in order for the patient to be able to ambulate, the ability of the caregivers to do what they need to do for the patient in the home environment, the ability for a therapist to be able to perform rehabilitative exercises with the patient, and of course, setting up a plan of care for the home health aide. The home health aide is the essential piece in carrying out the day-to-day tasks.
Hi, Michael Taylor.
Carlos Hernandez.
Come on in. This is Sarah, his nurse. Let me show you where you're going to be.
Sure.
The nurse will review the plan of care with the home health aide, which she prepared, and she will place that plan of care on the refrigerator.
Thank you. You have a lovely home, Mr. Taylor. I look forward to spending time here.
Carlos, you and Dad are going to be getting pretty close. You might as well call him by his first name. It's Walter.
It's Mr. Taylor. Well, I mean, Mr. Taylor will do fine for now. He's not from around here, is he?
I'm a New Yorker now. But you're right, Mr. Taylor. My family's country is nothing like the big city. It's warm all year round.
Yeah, well, I'm not one for the tropics. All that sun. It gives me a heat rash. Pass me my glasses.
Allow me?
Well, I guess I'm gonna have to get used to you fussing over me sooner or later.
Well, Dad, it sounds like your physical therapist is here.
Oh, I'll get it.
I hope you won't take my father's rough edges personally. He takes a while to warm up.
Oh, please, no need to worry. This is exactly what I was trained for. I look forward to getting to know your father and his own pace on his own terms.
Well, all right. Just know that he really isn't himself these days. I just hope he learns to trust you. And I just need to know that you'll be in touch with me if anything seems off. You know the risk factors in his
Michael,
history.
I am not afraid. And you should not be either. Let's just do this together, step by step.
Our caregivers are professionally trained to deal with any situation which may arise in the home, whether it's routine or an emergency. They're there to make decisions and to give you peace of mind.
He's fine. He's fine.
Thank God you're here, Carlos.
How did it happen?
He insisted on showering himself today. I was right outside the door, of course, but he slipped. As soon as I dialed 911, there was an ambulance here within minutes. I notified Americare, and Nurse Sarah was on call nearby, so she came on over. She examined the incision site, but he wasn't even in any pain. It was just a scare.
Just imagine if he'd been alone.
We can't thank you enough, Carlos.
If we didn't know before, now we can really feel confident about Dad's care.
Carlos, what's all the fuss going on over there? Tell those kids of mine to stop blowing things out of proportion and let's get on with our game. I'm about to outmaneuver your bishop into a checkmate like you've never seen before.
I'll be right there, Walter. I told you, he's fine.
Better than ever.
When our offices close at 5 o'clock, we have on-call services. Any patient can reach a registered nurse 24 hours.
We have an on-call in the evening. We have people in the office on the weekends. So anytime a patient or the families of the patients have any type of concerns, we're readily available to them. And their concerns are dealt with immediately.
Although the recovery process can be long, the combination of the patient being home together with the compassion of the home health aide is something that can really help the patient climb that mountain.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaking, and I gotta keep trying, keep my head held high, 'cause there's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. There's always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Side. It's a climb.
judgment knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most. Yeah, just gotta keep going, and I got to be strong.
Goal is to provide care so that they can reach that level of independence again. The only way to do that is if you follow them every step of the way and make sure that after they reach the peak at one level, you boost them up and you take them to the next until they've gotten to the point where they don't need you anymore.
Oh, I'm great.
Good to see you. Come on in.
Wow.
I'm so glad you finally made it out here, Nita.
Oh, Carlos, you have done a fabulous job with the place.
Thank you.
So, tell me about the new job. How's it going with that patient you're staying with?
Oh, amazing, really. He has made so much progress.
Yeah?
Yeah, he's getting around on his own now, sometimes even without a cane. He's so much more relaxed and focused. You know, I can't get over how far he's gotten.
Well, it sounds like you have some good stories to tell at the next family get together. I just hope it doesn't get to your head, hermanito. But seriously, that patient of yours is lucky to have you.
The truth is, Nita, I learned a lot from him too. You know, at first I wasn't sure whether I had the brains or the patience to deal with his stuff.
Mm.
But he depended so much on me that it forced me to be strong for him. Now that he doesn't need me as much, it won't be long until Americare sends me off to somewhere new.
Oh, Carlos. You sound like Mama used to talk. All sentimental.
I can't help it. You know, I feel really lucky. How many of my friends back home were able to get this chance to really make a difference in somebody's life? Besides, even though I won't be needed there as an aide any longer, I know that we'll keep in touch and stay friends.
Of course you will. You have made a difference in that man's life.
I'd like to make a toast to a really good kid.
Walter, you don't...
Mind your manners, son. Let me finish. Carlos, I know I put you through the ringer these last few months. And honestly, I wasn't sure you'd last. But you surprised me. You got me through a tough time. I won't miss having you bug me about my pills and my exercises. But I will miss having you around. Okay. I think Mike and Cheryl have a little something for you.
Just a token, Carlos. We are so grateful to you.
I'm the one who should be thanking all of you. Salud.
Salud.
Salud. Apple juice again. Did you switch my drinks?
I'm sorry.
So many things go into caring for a patient, a lot of details and clinical issues. But the essence of care is relationships. And that's Americare's tradition of caring.